I shared this meme on Facebook and on Instagram. It shows Medusa the Gorgon with her snake head saying, "Beware, I'm on prednisone." And I said that taking prednisone is even worse than the rage Medusa must feel for being banished and cursed with the death glare and the evil snake head. And somebody said that I was wrong, that roid rage from prednisone isn't real. I couldn't believe it. In fact, not only did they say it's not real, but that it's actually, any mood changes while you're on steroids are actually because you eat too much. Yeah, that's what they said. I couldn't believe it. And so I had to come on now to dismiss these myths and prove it with scientific research that I've been studying for years. Because I don't want anyone out there to be taking prednisone or any other steroid and feel like this and be dismissed and told that it's because you're eating too much. So here are my 7 myths busted about prednisone mood changes, specifically proving that roid rage is real. And who am I anyway? I'm Dr. Megan, your prednisone pharmacist. I am here to help you not just survive prednisone, but thrive while on prednisone. So here I'm going to get straight to the good stuff. So this poster who claims to be an expert about these things said, "Roid rage is a term used to describe what happens to bodybuilders when they take anabolic steroids." Now, I agree with that. That's true. Anabolic steroids raise testosterone, causing intense anger. Glucocorticoid steroids do not have that effect. So they're talking about anabolic, which is like the bodybuilder, like people who abuse steroids so they can win races. Do that. That's true. Glucocorticoids do not have that effect. Not true. When hydrocortisone or prednisone doses are too high, a person tends to eat too much and have feelings of sadness and depression. Anyone experiencing rage while taking glucocorticoid steroids has another hormone imbalance and should be tested for testosterone levels. Your meme is misleading people who don't understand steroids and making it harder for patients to navigate the world. So false. They started with truth. They started with a little bit of truth, and that's anabolic steroids are not prednisone. Prednisone is a glucocorticoid. Anabolic steroids are like testosterone, male hormones that boost your muscles. Prednisone takes away your muscles, saves lives. And so I said, I agree that the term roid rage is confusing. I'm sorry if it seems that it is making harder for patients to navigate the world. However, please understand that my intention is not to misinform. Rather, it is to make the time suffering while on steroids as pleasant as possible. One of the ways I've found to make life pleasant is through humor. Memes such as this one, which I did not create, I found online, help us accept our conditions and the situation we find ourselves in, because we realize we aren't alone in our suffering. I have to respectfully disagree that prednisone and other glucocorticoids don't cause rage as well. There is a multitude of scientific literature documenting the dramatic and sometimes terrible mood changes from prednisone. And then I also said, I receive phone calls at least once a week with people who had no previous mental illness and who are not suffering from excessive hunger, who are brand new to prednisone and are having extremely debilitating and miserable side effects. They are having anxiety that doesn't allow them to even get off their bed. They can't even handle watching TV. They can't be around their children. They're totally buzzed and incapable of functioning because of the mental changes that prednisone is causing in them. It has absolutely nothing to do with food. So here is the evidence. First is an article published in the Annals of New York Academy of Sciences called Effects of Glucocorticoids on Mood, Memory, and the Hippocampus. And this shows the first fact. First fact is that the most common mood changes from prednisone are mania. Fancy word for rage. Roid rage. I know it's attributed to anabolic steroids, but it happens with prednisone too, with glucocorticoids as well. Mania is the most common mood side effect. That means people are having serious, miserable feelings. And it says hypomania and mania are the most common mood changes during acute corticosteroid therapy, although depression has also been reported. Those are the top ones, mania and hypomania, like miniature mania. The second truth that we find out in here, this fact, is that both symptoms and the treatment response of the psychiatric mood changes while on prednisone and other steroids are similar to those of bipolar disorder. You know what bipolar disorder is? It's when you're high and low and high and low and high and low. What is that high? That high is mania, rage, crazy, like bouncing off the walls, inability to focus. Psychosis is what it's up at that high peak. Not for everybody, but those are possible features that's characteristic of roid rage. The third fact is that the mood changes are reversible when stopped. It specifically says corticosteroid-induced mood and cognitive alterations have been shown to be reversible with dose reduction or discontinuation of treatment. That means that it has absolutely nothing to do with your appetite. It has everything to do with the fact that you have this little bottle with pills in it and you took them and then you stopped taking them and the side effects go away. No bearing on whether you gained weight. No bearing on your appetite at all. Because fact number four is found in the also in the Annals of the New York Academy of the Sciences, and it's called Glucocorticoids, Mood, Memory, and Mechanisms. And this one teaches us that high levels of cortisol in the blood is related to psychiatric symptoms. So some people have psychiatric illnesses because their body is naturally making too much cortisol. It's as if they were taking a pill. Their body's just secreting too much cortisol and they're having psychiatric symptoms. Is it because they're having so much stress from those psychiatric illness, or is the psychiatric illness causing high levels of cortisol? Nobody knows, but they're related. So this has, again, nothing to do with appetite. Number five fact, myth busting, is that mood changes are very common. This is found in the Mayo Clinic proceedings. Mayo Clinic being one of the foremost medical institutions in the world. And they have this article called Glucocorticoids, Mood, Memory, and Mechanisms. Oops, that was the next one. And Mayo Clinic proceedings, it shows that psychiatric disturbances are common and include mania. Corticosteroid-induced psychiatric disturbances are common and include mania, depression, psychotic or mixed affective states, cognitive deficits, and minor psychiatric disturbances, which include irritability, insomnia, anxiety, and labile mood. Do you know what all of that is kind of saying in scientific ease? It's saying prednisone makes your mood change, makes you irritable, makes you rage, makes you miserable to be around. There's a reason there are memes out there that I didn't create, other people did, that talk about how you want your family will want to pack up and take a 6-month vacation from you while you're on prednisone because it changes your mood. I didn't make this up. My meme, which isn't even my meme, didn't make this up. This article goes on to say mild symptoms, and these are mild, okay? Because they're severe ones. These are the mild ones. The most frequently identified mild symptoms include agitation, anxiety, distractibility, fear, hypomania, indifference, insomnia, irritability, lethargy, labile mood, pressured speech, restlessness, and tearfulness. Does that sound like a very pleasant person to be around? No, it's not. This is real. This is documented. I've already shown you 4 articles. Would you like a 5th? Because I have one. This one is from Cambridge. Another one of the highest level of scientific rigor in the world, Cambridge University, British Journal of Psychiatry, says the mood changes are not from, this is my proving that the mood changes are not from testosterone. It is instead the HPA axis dysregulation. The HPA axis meaning the hypothalamic, pituitary, and adrenal glands, the cycle that your body goes through to make cortisol, okay? A dysfunction in glucocorticoid receptors is integral to the HPA abnormalities of mood disorders. Antidepressant and mood stabilizing drugs can upregulate glucocorticoid receptors, restoring glucocorticoid function. This is showing testosterone has nothing to do with mood symptoms while on prednisone. It is not the testosterone. It is not the male hormones. It is not the sex hormones. It is not androgens. Any of those terms you want to call it have nothing to do with the mood changes while on prednisone. It is the dysregulation, the messed up cycle that you have going on. It's supposed to be connecting your brain to your the pituitary, to your adrenal gland right above your kidneys. And it's being messed with while you're taking prednisone. It's interfering. It's stopping that cycle from happening. And that's what's causing the mood changes. Not testosterone. Not androgens. I've shown you 5 scientific articles that prove that it's not testosterone and it is not your appetite. These have nothing to do with mood changes. So my conclusion to this poster said, dismissing mood changes as a consequence of eating too much is incredibly harmful. It delegitimizes the true suffering people have from these terrible mood changes. I receive a phone call at least once a week from someone previously healthy who suddenly has disabling mood changes from anxiety, depression, to psychosis. It has absolutely no relationship to their diet or food intake. In fact, they are usually just starting steroid use and haven't even had the appetite changes hit them yet. It is just because of their steroid intake. So if somebody is dismissing your mood changes as it's all your fault, you're a terrible person, I'm going to divorce you, I'm going to fire you, whatever consequence you are suffering with right now, I am sorry. And for those around you, I am sorry. Prednisone and other glucocorticoids are miraculous drugs, but they come at a huge cost, and this is one of them. These mood changes are disabling, real, and not caused by you. They are caused by the drug. They are caused by the dysregulation of your systems from taking the drug. And you're taking the drug probably because there's something terrible going on. For me, I had to take the drug because I was otherwise going to bleed to death. It saved my life. I'm here to tell you, the other side of the story. I've lost my moon face. My moods are my own now. There is recovery. There is another side to this. And so if you are one of those suffering mood changes after taking prednisone, you can share this with your family. You can share this with your boss. You can share this with your friends, whoever is being affected around you, to say, look, it's real and it's not my fault and I'm sorry. And the one thing I need from you right now is understanding. Because when we can see that it's not you, it's the drug, then we can have compassion. then we can have love. We can have understanding, forgiveness, and we can heal those broken relationships caused by taking a life-saving drug. That's what I want for you today, is to share this with your family, friends, associates who are being affected by you taking prednisone and other steroids, so that they can understand, that they can comprehend that this is real and it's not your fault. And you will heal. It takes time. And you might need to take other medications to help you get through this rough time while you're on prednisone. But they can help. There is hope. That's the thing people are so lacking these days. There is hope. Signing off as Dr. Megan, your prednisone pharmacist.